Welcome to Creative Matchup presented by Adobe, where designers go head-to-head in an all-out creative battle. In our last episode, we had Jeannie Ngo, George Kettenberg, and Jordan Smith going head-to-head to see who could design and prototype an entirely new feature for a mobile app in under 4 hours using Adobe XD. All three competitors did an excellent job in their initial designs, but when it came to the elimination round, things got a little out of control.
I don't know if I have enough stuff on the board.
If I don't make it through this mini challenge, it's gonna suck.
So know that we are fully aware that 30 minutes is not a lot of time, but the clock did work against you, and two of you did shine over the others. The person that we have to eliminate is Jeannie. Jeannie, if you had more time to flush out your ideas on paper and get into your process, it would have been even tougher. And sometimes you have to get just right to the design.
I feel defeated. I feel like I tried my best. If this was my real creative brief, like, I would tell you that I respect their company, their brand, and their creative work. I would need more time than this.
It's really sad to see Jeannie go, but I guess I'm just happy I'm still here.
All right, we know that was very tough, but let's get that clock started and get back to work.
Most of us aren't used to working in such crazy timelines like this, and you really have to like throw away a lot of your process to kind of get something out that looks good to a judge. Jordan, she's funny, she's cool. She is a good trash talker for sure.
George is a super talented guy and he brings an interesting perspective to this. But he ain't no girl.
Man, getting into my head.
So now that you've had a little bit more time with Adobe XD, are you finding some new tools, anything new and useful going on?
The asset panel is really nice to grab very quick type styles, and you know, it changes across the different comps.
I love it. So now, I mean, your odds have increased dramatically to win this whole thing. What do you think your odds are? How confident are you in your work?
I think my odds are 50%. But, you know, I'm feeling pretty confident.
My impression of George is that he's really empathetic and passionate, and I really respect him.
What's up, George? Now that you're in the second half of this thing, can you tell me a little bit about what you're doing differently?
Yeah, I think at this point you kind of start have to prioritizing the stuff that you're actually going to design, and the worst thing you can do, I think, is bite off more than you can chew and end up with nothing working.
A really great feature in Adobe XD is the combination of design and prototyping in the same application. Certain types of projects, you need certain types of prototypes, and I think Adobe XD really does a great job with the prototypes that are just a great way to get your point across and to show some on how a flow kind of pieces together.
Designers, you have 1 hour left. Just 1 hour. Make it count.
My idea isn't simple, but I'm going to try to get it done with having to make as few items as possible.
Being able to see things happen in real time on my device was super efficient for me to make sure that I'm not making things too small, making things too light, tap targets are usable, and that you're not doing anything weird.
Oh, just 15 minutes left. Keep it going.
There's only so much more that you can do in 15 minutes.
When pressure's on, like you know you might be missing something.
I feel like everything's tightened up. I double checked my prototype and everything looked good.
1 minute, designers, just 1 minute left.
You know, there's nothing more I can do, and I just have to be okay with that.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, that's it! Hands off your computers! Wow, what you accomplished in 4 hours is absolutely incredible, but there can only be one winner. And now it's time to present your final projects to the judges.
I'm really confident about what I'm presenting. I really like it. I think I can sell it well.
I really wanted to give you a broader idea of who this woman is. One thing you'll notice that I have in the skills is little dots, and those dots correlate to the skills you yourself have pointed out that you are interested in or focused in. They can also expand posts. And I've also brought in the claps feature, so a woman would still, you know, press the fab. Send a video message. You can also see where she's raised her hand, ask for help. You can see what other women like gave a clap to and, you know, raised up.
Awesome, I really like the design you have here, how you incorporated the existing style guide to your app, so it's really consistent.
I like your design. It's really emotional. You gave an emotional and personal touch to it.
I think you've done a wonderful job creating an app that's more of a vehicle of empathy, which is super awesome. Overall, it's exciting, and I feel like it's an advancement from the product that was there before.
So what I presented at the end was basically a revamp of the profile experience, really letting the girl shine through and letting her highlight the things that she's interested in and make it a real reflection of who she is.
I went with a card kind of pattern for this profile. Basically, this top card is a little kind of short intro about this person. I thought that a fun thing to do would be have some emoji badges that you could collect from special events. So maybe this one is when you attend an all-night hackathon. We've got a progress section to show how they're doing with the languages they're learning, a list of the clubs that she's a member of, and so that's a quick way for her to jump into those clubs. A place to highlight their projects. I'm sure these girls are making some really cool things. A little H scroll of just recent posts that she's made. This definitely turns it into a platform that you can really build and grow off of.
Great job overall. I'm really impressed with the executions. It's really beautiful, but it's also super functional. So.
Great job, George. You added like a lot of features and made it totally functionable, which is really good. I like the customization feature as well.
Yeah, I think it functions beautifully as a profile. My concern is I don't know how it functions as a community piece, because I feel that might be an important thing to an organization like this.
George, Jordan, what you both have accomplished in 4 hours is absolutely amazing. Now it's time to see what the judges have to say.
Jordan, you really captured the heart of Girls Who Code. That showed in the experience and in your design. George, the amount of design and prototyping that you could do on the profile page, you really did a great job with this challenge. But ultimately, this is a design challenge that came down to who met the client's needs the best. And the winner of this creative matchup is George.
George, you did it! Congratulations!
Thanks, man.
You, my man, are the champion. Woo! Right here.
It's really challenging when you don't have role models and you don't have the things that other people have to look up to. So a foundation like Girls Who Code is super important.
Well, that's it for this episode of Creative Matchup. We'll see you next time.